Subscribe to Ninja's Craziest. Press the bell icon and never miss another video update.
Ninja's Craziest is not a review of any political parties, individuals, or religious group. This show is just for comedy purposes only. It might contain scenes with strong languages, strong satirical humor, links to a relative you might know, and references some may find offensive. If that kind of thing will offend you, Biko, close your browser now and
get out of here. Get out of here, man! Shit, I'm saying!
Because that's what we did!
Comedians are absolutely insane.
You know, we love Hubert Angel so much.
Because he's our good friend.
Hubert Angel, you know, he's a very eloquent man of God. Man of native gods. He's a very eloquent man of native gods.
Speaks very well with full 100% confidence.
But my only surprise is that his son, his God's son, did not pick up that eloquence.
He will pick up very soon. They are trying to imbibe him into that full ministry.
You know, Bushiri is not very smart. He's not as smart as his godfather.
Yeah.
His godfather is very eloquent. He can easily...
No, because he did not finish learning.
Bushiri did not graduate.
He ran away, did not do graduation.
Oh, okay.
He ran away.
Okay.
What he was trying to imbibe in his life was too much for him. Mm. That's why we were able to expose him very fast.
Okay, true.
That's why he used this tie. Have you ever met before?
Ever noticed before?
Ever spoken.
Okay, so let's watch Hubert Angel try to juggle his way around the fact that he's a charlatan. He's the head charlatan.
Yes.
Let's try.
And he gathers some people because the thing looks like a show. He want to perform. So there are a lot of people around him.
Basket
so he's cracking jokes to them, so they were laughing.
Some
people that have been brainwashed.
They are there sitting there opening their brown teeth and be laughing. Mm.
Some people that they've stolen all their glory.
Their glory.
They don't have anything. Okay, maybe they've surrendered. They know that they have nothing to do. This
Pastor will buy them house and buy them car now. So they will clap.
That one is enough for them. What do they want to do?
So when they leave the church, Pastor will collect it. They go back to obeying Papa.
They go back to square one.
Okay, so watch Hubert Angel, then we'll talk when we come back.
This is why I say all this fight Christians do. For what? These pastors you are fighting, who told you they've not repented yesterday? Let's say what you are saying is correct, which is a lie anyway. But what if they repented 2 days ago? What if they repented last night? And you are still there judging them? What is this? Life is all about peace. Christianity is love. We can differ in doctrine, but never be vindictive. Now just imagine, people can die on this earth, be recorded in heaven as dead, and you still haven't repented. Where are you going to go with this? What is your life going to be? He that steals, steal no more. He that sins, sin no more. Why? Because there is this day that will come. But if people can die whilst we are with them, who is to say you are still alive? I didn't get it. Who is to say in the book of God you are not dead yet? Who is to say that? But there might be a chance somewhere. I don't know how. There might be a chance. I don't know why you are still here for the next 2 days, next 2 years, next 20 years. Why you're still here for the next 40 years. I don't know why. Maybe you are just being given an opportunity to repent and change your ways. Maybe. This is it. But you are still busy bickering, Christians fighting, planning for each other. And the most important thing is this, that we are only fighting because I'm saying your sin is greater than my sin. The dead don't die.
What is dead may never die.
Even the ones who sin will go to hell and they'll still be alive there. It's a different life, but you'll still be alive there. So what do we do now? If all these are life, what do we do? Where do we go from here? Christ is coming very, very soon. And we are busy. It's like every moment, every minute, we waste on planning for this one. Planning again is this one. Sinning again is this one. Sinning again is this one. God does not care who wronged you. Said, how many times shall I forgive my brother? What did he say? 7 times what? 77. times seven. What was he saying? Infinite. Get to a point immediately where you fix your life. Fix your life yourself, I fix mine. It's a whole lot of things. Visions happen. But what are you seeing in visions? Who are we on earth to God? We are past the tense. God has finished with this whole earth and is sitting there thinking, I know the end from the beginning and the beginning from the end. We are already God's past tense. Life is in blocks. Time is in blocks. The past block is still alive as it is. When God mixes it up together, that's when you see things that you have never seen in your life. Let me tell you something. Go by scripture. Go by scripture. And always understand, let this be your feeding trough. Don't be with everything. You know, everything. You are not a spiritual prostitute. Find a source where you get your information. Today this, tomorrow that, tomorrow this. Who are you? Are you United Nations of the Gospel? Ah. Spiritual Columbus. Traveling everywhere. Did you hear what they said? So what now? Come on. Get to the point. This is what is important. All these people here, one day, all of you here will be dead. And what will come will be this. Not what somebody said, but Lord, I was just deceived by someone. No. That person was able to deceive you because you had no word. If you have the word, nobody can deceive you. In fact, if you have the word, you won't be looking for anyone who is saying anything. So you'll be like, I'm just sticking to the word. That's it. It's time the body joins. Remember what the Bible told us about? That demons themselves don't fight. It says, if the devil fights the devil, how is his kingdom going to stand? If in the kingdom of the devil, it's straightforward. The demons don't fight. They even invite each other to possess a person. Cast out brings seven more that are more powerful than. It's more powerful than. It will be like, if I bring these big guys, they might remove me. No, like, let's go, guys. You would even be able to protect our space there. And they get in there. And these are seven. In one legion, there were how many? 6,000. Now, these ones are seven only. So imagine the space. They've land inside. I'm telling you, these ones, they have farms and gardens and streets, even cars inside, honestly. Six. The same body that can fit 6,000, they are now just 8. Ah. No. So listen. Now, imagine what the Bible says. It says, guard your heart. From it are the issues of life. If the Bible says, guard your heart, yet you are free to give it to anyone. Any little thing. You know what happened to me? What have you done? You're opening your heart to people that are affected. It says guard your heart because it's tender. Imagine even Jesus, when he comes to your heart, he knocks. Jesus himself knows he should have a key. And the Bible says guard it. From it are the issues of life. Guard from messages that can look nice, but they're damaging. Rumor that can look sweet. Bible says rumor looks like sweet morsel. Gossip is like sweet morsel. It's like a waffle that's so sweet. It's nice to consume. But in the end, it will kill you. To kill your spirit. I saw what's happening in Nigeria right now, where a man is just talking anyhow about big people of God. Just anyhow, anything that comes out of his mouth. Nigeria. Just saying whatever. The Bible says, old people in the church, treat them as fathers. Old women as mothers, treat them as mothers. It didn't say if they are so nice, if you agree with them. No. The age alone should be respected. That's it. The age should be respected. The church, if you are in my church, never be seen ever again opposing men of God. Even the ones who claim to be men of God and are not. Shut up. It's none of your business. Continue with what the Bible says. That's all you do. That's my advice. You hell, you heap up for yourself curses that you don't need in your life. Oh, I don't believe, I don't agree with Adeboye. I don't agree with this one. I don't agree with this one. Who asked your opinion? Relax, guys. Let's work. I'm talking about my church here. I'm not talking about people who oppose men of God out there. My church, mine, don't get involved. Don't oppose nobody. Even the one who is pretending to be a man of God, don't oppose them. Even the ones who are opposing people, don't oppose them. Concentrate on the Bible. Stick to this. Don't even go for, oh, this one is opposing my father, I'm going to kill him. No. Forgive that one too. It says, pray for those who are your enemies. Bless them. Imagine. It says, bless them. Do you know how difficult it is when you start praying for your enemy and blessing them? You know you've matured. You know, like your father in the name, I bless that enemy of mine. you don't need anyone to say you are mature now. You've matured. Thank you so much, guys. And I love you so much. And continue to watch out for part two of The Walking Dead. All right.
You can see.
Have you seen that? Have you heard?
You can see that. Man of God is trying to respond to allegations.
Yes.
J. Israel called you a fraudster. We called you a fraudster.
Everything.
How does this man of the gods respond? What did he say?
You know the part that baffles me. It was this part that he said, why are you talking about them? Those people that you are talking about, you don't know if they have repented yesterday. Are you stupid? Then you see,
he said they have repented yesterday.
We did not say they should not repent. That's why we are doing this. You have been doing all your faith miracles, money laundering, everything in what public. So if you want to repent, come out in public. Look at J. Israel. He even brought somebody on live video. One of the big team of that time, because he's of the past now. He came live, he said about it. He said it in public, the things he have done when he was in the world, when he was with these charlatans. Now he came in public and what?
Restitution.
Restitution, yes.
He did his restitution for everybody to see.
And we see very well. Even one of the big team, we saw her live. Please, even if you have repented in private, we did not know. You might see do something tomorrow.
Did he come and admit the allegations?
That's where we are talking. Come out in public and say it.
Admit all the allegations, all the things you have done. Admit it first.
Yes.
That is the first step to repentance.
Yes.
Don't come and tell us that Christians are fighting Christians. This one is fighting this. Mm. That demons don't fight demons. Of course, you and your boys. You will never fight each other.
Yes, because you know how you got started.
Because demons don't fight demons.
How do I put it?
You know?
Yes.
You are telling us, because we are stupid, that what if they are repented? That they should stop talking about man of God. Touch not the anointed.
He was not using a lot of things in the Bible.
Go back to, travel back to South Africa or Zimbabwe. If they born your father well, Shebi, you have repented yesterday. Go back to Zimbabwe.
The way that I love our God. He always give room.
God is very patient.
Patient. He give room.
If this was Ogun, one better slap would have landed on this man's face.
If Ogun touch him, in best time, go come out. For his face,
and he's so confident.
Your
confidence borders on arrogance.
You don't know when they catch thief, like the way catch something, where thief something, you they catch like the go say, I know thief, I just won't take him. It is when a group will come out and say, yes, I've done this. You are now trying to, you know, let people come to your side, bringing people to
brainwashing them. They are there clapping with their brown teeth.
Still using, I hate the way people use Bible again. To back up all the
I have told you that the Bible, there's everything to back up everything you do in the Bible. There's a verse to back up every wrongdoing you have done in the Bible. That is what these men do.
Is this charlatans? That's what they are trying to do. These things you guys are doing, it is better you repent or else
he has repented yesterday.
Yeah, in private. Did he tell you?
That is what he said. Let's believe what he said. He repented yesterday. No, he said, what if?
What if they are you are here shouting, just saying, they are this, they are that. My brother, it is best for you. You have duped people in public. You have lied in public. You have fake miracle in public. Please, come and confess in public. Beg those victims that you have rendered useless, that you have destroyed their vision. Come out in public and say it, so that the world will forgive you and God too.
All the women you have given STD, mm-hmm. you have infected. Mm-hmm. Call them out. All the girls you have done a quirk with.
And all those people you have paid money to not to expose
you. All the things, they cover up.
Please.
Let's come out to say it. That your charge and bail lawyer that keeps sending us email. Let him stop sending us email, Okwaya.
If he send us money,
to cover up.
We will cover our mouth.
Nonsense. Hey. My people, thank you for watching, Jare.
Don't mind us. Even if he send us money, should we say it now so that they will know?
If he send us money,
we will still expose your papa.
We will chop your money.
I'll expose you again. So better keep your money. But if you have sense, you wish to, maybe you want to bribe us more. It depends on the level of your... Don't let us see it. Just leave it. Don't worry.
Let your lawyer can. You know how he communicates with us now, mm-hmm. with his rubbish charge and bail email.
Yes.
Go and hire a good lawyer. Don't go and be hiring charge and discharge lawyer. Bye bye. We'll see you on the next episode. Don't forget to like and subscribe and watch our videos and share. Very important. Subscribe.
Click the
notification bell so that we hear Pakam.
Immediately we drop every video. Now it's like the video will be dropping back to back.
You know?
Don't worry. Content. All these charlatans will be exposed.
There are contents plenty. You see this 2020. Whereas 2020 wants to crease. Let's crease along with it.
Yes, because 2020 don't damage.
Let's damage. Let all of us go damage it.